الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أرسله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله ولو كره الكافرون يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار We start with the name of Allah, we start with Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim and every new beginning starts with the name of Allah. So we say Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim and Allah has allowed us to enter into this new year. And a whole year has passed by. And we've seen another year come in our lives. And we start this year with the name of Allah, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. And who is this Allah? He's ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, the most merciful in all universals and the most merciful in all particular matters. That is Allah, that He has And whatever mercy that we can imagine, we have that mercy is still less than the mercy of Allah. Allah Azza wa Jalla says, "Wasi'at rahmati kulla shay," that my mercy has encompassed everything. Everything. Any difficulty and any ease we find in our lives is a mercy. And amongst the mercies that Allah has sent us is the reminders, the ayat that He has sent us. Those ayat in the Quran. And those ayat outside of the Quran, the ayat, the signs that point back to Him, Azza wa Jal, the signs that point back to Him and remind us of Him. That's the ayat. Literally, an ayat is a sign, and so those ayat that point back to Him. One of the poets said, "Wallahi ma hadha al-wujud illa mushiru lil-ma'bud." That I swear by Allah, that this existence is nothing except an indication of the one that should be worshipped. And so, among the signs that Allah has given us. Is the turning of the night and day, the passing of time. And so Allah has given us, has been merciful to us to see the passing of time. And for us to remember with this passing of time that we are going to one day leave this world. And inshallah, when we leave this world, when we depart with smiling faces. And we depart happily because we were people, inshallah, who saw the signs of Allah and took those signs as indications and reminded ourselves of what those signs were pointing towards. That those signs were all pointing towards the one that should have been worshipped, Azza wa Jal. And so this new year comes in. We should take this as a sign, as a reminder that Allah is able to change the night and day. Allah has put the planets and the moon and the sun, the solar system in orbit, and all the celestial bodies of this galaxy, and of this galaxy and all the galaxies, He has put into orbit. The entire universe, Allah has so perfectly, in such an organized system, put it together. And in us, He has put signs in ourselves as well. So Allah says, "وَفِي أَنفُسِكُمْ أَفَلَا تُبْصِرُونَ," that we have put signs inside of you. Do you not ponder? Do you not have insight into this? So Allah reminds us of these signs that are found everywhere. But the sign of the turning of the night and day that Allah has given us is a reminder for us of our purpose, that our time here is limited, that time is passing away, that there's not a single breath that we take except it expires, except a portion of our life expires, as Ibn al-Fadl rahimahullah says, that a portion of our life is expiring every time we take a breath. And these are reminders for us to reform ourselves and to orient ourselves back towards Allah. That throughout the day and throughout the weeks and throughout the months and years, we find ourselves sometimes disorienting from Allah. Sometimes we miss the signposts. We miss the reminders. But these reminders come. Major reminders come. A turning of a whole year comes to remind us of where we're supposed to be going. So people say things like new year, new me in the beginning of the year. I think it's better to say new day, new me, or new moment, new me, because Allah is recreating His creation every single moment. So that we should be better than the moment that passed before. So if Allah can turn the night and days, we should ask Allah that He also turn our hearts towards Him. If He can turn the night and days, He surely can turn our hearts back towards Him. And so we ask Allah that He allows us to have the tawfiq to be on His obedience, to have ta'a. So we say, Ya muqallib al-qulub, thabbit qulubana ala dinik. We say, O turner of hearts, make our hearts firm on your deen, wa ala ta'atik, and your obedience. And so these reminders that come for us throughout our lives, every moment is a reminder. But sometimes it takes a major reminder for us to kind of catch it. Sometimes you need a major sign. You know, a lot of times we miss the forest for the trees, right? We miss all the minor. We're looking at like all the minor things that happen in our lives, and we miss the big picture. The big picture that we weren't here made for play. We were made for. We weren't here to waste time. We weren't here to earn money. We weren't here to pursue careers. Those things are all good things to do. We should be providing for ourselves and our families. And with the right intention, that is also obedience. And that is also worship. But for us to make that worship, we need to orient ourselves towards Allah and orient our actions towards Allah. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ وَلِسَائِرِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ يَا قَوْمِ اسْتَغْفِرُوا إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. Any moment that we find ourselves distracted and we think to ourselves that perhaps I'm not worth worshiping Allah, perhaps I've messed up too many times to go back, then we've underestimated the mercy of Allah. When Allah says وَسِعَتْ رَحْمَتِي كُلَّ شَيْءٍ, that my mercy encompasses everything, He means everything. And so Allah has the power for us to turn us to people who are oriented towards Him. That we might have moments in our lives where we slip up, but we have a tawbah from those, right? We have a repentance, and tawbah literally means to turn. That we turn away from those things and turn back to Allah, orient ourselves back towards Allah. We make the intention, the resolve. Right, we talk about new resolutions, right? We make the resolve to make a tawbah. Right? That's part of a tawbah, to make a resolve not to go back to what we were doing. And if we slip up, then go back to it again. And if we slip up and go back to it again, then turn back. We have the opportunity to turn back to the last moments of our breath. That we disobey Allah in ways that we don't even recognize. Moment after moment. But Allah has the power to turn our hearts back to Him if we ask. And if we come to Allah walking, He comes to us running. Azza wa Jalla has mentioned the hadith of the Prophet. We ask Allah that He allows us to be people who recognize His mercy and people who seek His mercy. We ask Allah that He makes us people who are consistent in seeking His mercy and consistent in seeing the mercy in every moment that He gives us and every sign that He gives us. We ask people that we be people that see these signs. The people who have the inner core hearts, the people of Lubab, that Al-Bab, people who have the inner core hearts and look and see the signs and take reminders from them. We ask Allah that He allows us to have many more barakah-filled years to come. And if He takes us in this year, or if someone that we know has been taken in this year, that He forgives us when He takes us, and that we meet Allah smiling, and we meet Allah knowing how to answer His questions on the Day of Judgment, we ask Allah that He removes any sort of difficulty from us from the Day of Judgment, any difficulty that we may experience in this last year that passed, or this year that's to come, or any of our years, any of our moments, we ask Allah that He allows us to be that to be expiation of any difficulty that might come in the hereafter. We ask Allah that we are people who seek His mercy. We ask Allah He makes us merciful to His creation, so that Ar-Rahman can have can have his rahmah on us, that Ar-Rahman, the most merciful, will have mercy on us. We ask Allah to be people of mercy. We ask Allah to be receivers of mercy, recipients of mercy. We ask Allah to be givers of mercy. We ask Allah to be recipients of signs and giver of signs. We ask Allah that He allows us to be people who have firmness on His deen and firmness on following His Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We ask Allah that He allows us to see the signs, and we ask Allah that we find no peace other than Him. So we say, Allahumma anta salam wa minka salam tabarakta ya dhal jalali wal ikram hayyina wa adkhilna dar as-salam rabbana atina fid dunya hasana wa fil akhirati hasana wa qina adhaban nar. We ask Allah to recognize that Allah and His angels send their mercy and blessings on the Prophet ﷺ, and we ask to do the same. Inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusalluna ala al-Nabi. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu sallu alayhi wa sallimu taslima. Allahumma salli ala sayyidina habibina wa qurrati ayunina Muhammad wa ala azwaji sayyidina Muhammad wa ala ali sayyidina Muhammad wa ala ashabi sayyidina Muhammad wa ala atba'i sayyidina Muhammad wa ala ahbabi sayyidina Muhammad wa ala ummati sayyidina Muhammad wa barik wa sallim wa salli alayhi. إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون اذكروا الله يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون وأقيموا الصلاة.